So friends, welcome back. I'm Professor G.N. Purohit from the Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, Bikaner, Rajasthan and India. And today I deliver my next lecture, and that is on infertility. Now, we will be covering in a series of lectures the infertility in different farm domestic animals. And today we talk something about the basics of the bovine infertility, and we will be covering the morphologic, anatomic or the morphologic causes of bovine infertility. The fertility, it relates to follicle development and maturation, estrus onset, the successful coitus or artificial insemination, ovulation, fertilization, implantation, development and delivery of the fetus and its membranes. And the world standard for fertility is the conception rate. Fertility is affected by various factors. See, the age. Fertility declines with increasing parities. It is also dependent on the production. With increased milk production, the fertility is comparatively lower. Disease, maybe mastitis or retained placenta, they may affect the fertility of dairy cows. The artificial control of estrus, this may also affect the fertility. Then nutrition and management are two factors which govern or regulate the fertility of dairy cows. Now, infertility, when we are talking of infertility, infertility is considered as temporary loss of fertility, or it is also now known as the subfertility. Cattle and buffaloes are considered infertile when they are neither normally fertile nor sterile. The interest in bovine infertility increased with introduction of artificial insemination in 1950s. Now, decreasing fertility is a worldwide problem. It has been recently reported that fertility in cows has been declining in USA, UK, Netherlands, Ireland, France, Spain, Quebec, etc. over the last many years. And basically, this appears to be selection of dairy cows for years together only and only for milk production. The reproduction has been overlooked and or it has been given lesser importance, and this has reduced the fertility. Now, infertility in dairy cattle or maybe in many domestic animal species can be classified into the congenital or the morphological anatomic causes, the functional causes and the infectious causes. Here in this chart you can see that morphologic, maybe congenital or maybe acquired anatomic causes. Then the functional causes include an estrus, sub-estrus, ovarian cysts, repeat breeding. And the infectious causes include the specific infections which are caused by many bacteria, viruses, fungi and protozoa, and the non-specific infections affecting the genital tract, maybe metritis, maybe endometritis, pyometra, cervicitis, mucometra, etc. Now today we will focus on the congenital and the acquired morphological anatomic causes of infertility in dairy cattle. The congenital morphologic causes can be freemartin, a double cervix, uterus unicornis, uterus diadelphus, and the acquired causes can be ovaro-bursal adhesions, uterine adhesions, perineal lacerations, and tumors. The congenital, first we discuss about the congenital morphological causes of infertility in dairy cattle. The congenital morphological causes are the developmental abnormalities of the genital tract and include ovarian hypoplasia, freemartins, hermaphrodites, white heifer disease, and then morphological abnormalities of the genital tract including the double cervix. Here in this picture you can see there are two cervices, then uterus unicornis. In this picture you can see they only a uterus has only one uterine horn, and then uterus didelphys, and the hymenal defects and others. The acquired causes we'll be discussing later on. Now the first congenital morphologic cause of infertility in dairy cattle is ovarian hypoplasia. It's also known as the germ cell weakness. This condition affects Swedish Highland cattle and Swedish white and red cattle as well. The affected heifers have low number of primordial follicles and hypoplastic or ill-developed ovaries. Hypoplasia is generally left-sided, or it may be in most of the cases it is left-sided, whereas it can be bilateral or in the right side of the ovary also. Ovaries are small, less than 1 gram, and partially hypoplastic ovaries are 4 to 8 grams. The ovaries have furrows, are very small in size, and the affected heifers do not express any estrus or pregnancy. They neither evidence CL or follicles on the ovaries. Now, this ovarian hypoplasia can be diagnosed if the heifer is of a breedable age, but it's not coming to estrus or it's with the bull and yet not becoming pregnant. So these heifers can be examined, and if they are having very small hypoplastic ovaries, we can then perform some ultrasound examinations, and biopsy of these ovaries can confirm the hypoplasia. Then a second condition which is common in cattle, it's also known as intersex or commonly called as the freemartin. A freemartin is a female twin born co-twin to a male. Now genetically, female fetus masculinized in the presence of a male co-twin gives rise to a sterile heifer. The genital tract defects with varying severity can be observed in freemartin animals. Uterine horns are hypoplastic or cord-like, and anatomic continuity between the uterus and the vagina is frequently absent. The placental anastomosis between the heterozygotic twins results in blood chimerism, and passage of male gonad determinants or the hormones to the female fetus. This results into a female with external genitals, female-like, yet defects in the internal genitals. Here in this picture you can see fetuses with different sexes, and because of the anastomosis of the placenta, the male fetus, it becomes active earlier as compared to the female fetus, and it starts secreting androgens which then cross over to the female fetus, resulting into masculinization of the female fetus. The females born, freemartins born, will have fish hook shaped vulva. Their cervix is underdeveloped or many a times absent. There is an enlarged clitoris. When these heifers grow up, you find an enlarged clitoris, a small vulva, and tuft of hair. The urine emission in these heifers is in upward spurts. They have a small size vulva and rudimentary uterus. The small size vagina ends in a blind pouch. The presence of vesicular glands was a constant feature. The seminal vesicles in a phenotypic female, this is a constant feature of a freemartin. In these pictures, you can see that this heifer, it has got angulation of the vulvar lips, spurts of urine passing upwards rather than being passed downwards, and the clitoral hypertrophy. Now, for testing of a freemartin heifer, invariably 92 to 98% of the times the female calves, they are sterile and they will have a small vagina without continuity of the uterus. The vagina ends in a blind pouch. Commercially, one applicator is available, and when we introduce the applicator in a normal heifer, it will pass to a certain length. But in a freemartin heifer, it will have a cul-de-sac vagina, and so the applicator does not pass beyond a certain length. This can confirm, then we can go in for cytogenetic evaluations of these heifers, or maybe we can examine these heifers by ultrasound and find the deformities in the uterus and the genital tract as well. These heifers might not be able to reproduce, and hence they had to be culled out. These were some of the congenital defects. Even heifers having two cervices or maybe uterus unicornis is difficult to become pregnant, and because of their partial heritability, it has been mentioned that these cows should not be bred, or the heifer should not be bred. Now we discuss about the acquired morphological causes of infertility. The most frequent and the most common acquired anatomic or the morphologic cause of infertility in dairy cows is ovaro-bursal adhesions. The incidence varies from 1 to 17% in different studies. Ovaro-bursal adhesions are common in adult pluripares cows. The infections of the bursa may occur following metritis, pyometra, or the presence of a macerated fetus, or ovulation and rough ovarian palpations. The infusion of large volumes of intrauterine drugs can result into ovaro-bursal adhesions. Also, tuberculous peritonitis or systemic infections can sometimes cause ovaro-bursal adhesions. On palpation, or maybe on examining the genital tract subsequent to the death of the animal, or maybe because of slaughter, then we find fine web-like strands to complete fibrosis on the bursa. These can also be evaluated in live animals by transrectal palpation or maybe transrectal ultrasonography. The web-like strands are often attached to a scar or regressing CL. They may be unilateral or bilateral. Cows with bilateral ovaro-bursal adhesions many a times become sterile. The oviducts may be occluded, resulting in hydrosalpings and sometimes even pyosalpings. The diagnosis is dependent on transrectal palpation, maybe ultrasonography. A test to determine the patency of the fallopian tubes or the oviduct is the PSP dye test. In this test, a dye is infused in one of the uterine horns. This dye, if the fallopian tube is not occluded, would then enter the peritoneum, and from there it will be absorbed and it will change the color of the urine. Most of the times, therapy of such cases is not possible when they are bilateral. In cows with unilateral ovaro-bursal adhesions, maybe they become pregnant from the other side of the ovary, if that is normal. Then cervical cirrhosis the it has been mentioned that the bosindicus types of heifer cows, they develop physiological cervical hypertrophy with increasing number of parities, and this may sometimes result into fibrotic tissue developing on the cervix. The cervical cirrhosis may also result from cervicitis, and cervicitis is considered by some when the second cervical fold prolapses with reddening. Poor manipulative procedures during difficult births may result into subsequent cervicitis, and if not attended, then cervical cirrhosis. The cervicitis does not affect fertility when the uterus is not involved and artificial insemination is the means of breeding. Carefully inseminated cows may become pregnant and deliver normally. Cervical tears can result in fibrotic changes when unattended. Then the acquired morphologic causes of infertility may be certain tumors that may occlude the lumen, that may obstruct the passage of the gametes. The common tumors on the vulvine vagina include squamous cell carcinoma, fibroma, and fibropapilloma. The fibroma type of tumors can be surgically removed, but many a times the squamous cell carcinoma, the therapy fails. Adenocarcinoma, leiomyomas, and fibroma are common in the uterus. Fibroma can again be removed from the uterus of a cow and by a flank laparotomy or maybe by other approaches. But the fertility of such cows is poor to guarded. So that was all for the morphologic causes of infertility in the bovine species. Thank you very much. If you like this video, kindly share it and subscribe to my channel, Govind Narayan Purohit. Thank you. Thank you very much.